Considering that the same DNA is found in all of our cells, and we produce proteins according to this identical DNA sequence, then how can different tissues and organs produce different proteins? For example, how does our digestive system produce proteins, enzymes that digest the food that we eat, but those same digestive enzymes are not produced by our lungs, even though we have the same genes in our lung cells? You'll find out in this video. Hello and thank you for joining me. I'm the Biotech Girl and today I'm excited to tell you about the amazing ways in which our bodies regulate the expression of the genes. I have to highlight that the gene regulation doesn't only occur in humans, but in all living organisms, including prokaryotes and eukaryotes. However, in the next few minutes, I will focus on the ways in which the eukaryotic cells regulate the gene expression. Let's start off with a definition. A gene is basically a DNA sequence that can be expressed into a functional product. What this means is that the DNA can be transcribed into a functional RNA molecule, or that RNA sequence can further be translated into a functional protein sequence. These are the processes of transcription and translation. To help us determine which protein is created from a given DNA sequence or gene, there's a universal genetic code. This genetic code is the same for all living organisms that we know of. In different cells, some genes can be switched on and they can be switched off in other cells according to the cell type, the cell's location, or the overall condition of the organism. So the cells can also enhance the protein production or inhibit it. The genes that are found in the DNA are responsible for the production of proteins in all living organisms with the help of the intermediating molecule RNA. This is known as gene expression. The gene expression is regulated by a number of mechanisms, and I've tried to categorize them into 4 categories. As I mentioned earlier, the gene expression involves the DNA molecule in which the gene is located, and the final product, which can be either an RNA that has its own function, or in most cases, this RNA molecule gets translated into a particular protein. Some additional regulatory molecules are involved in this process, like some binding molecules called histones, transcription factors, enzymes, microRNA. Let's collectively call them the others. I'm kidding, as biologists we must give them a more complicated name, like regulatory molecules. It makes sense that the gene expression can be regulated on each step, on a level of the DNA, RNA, the proteins, and the regulatory molecules. Let's see how this regulation occurs on each of these 4 levels. On a DNA level, the gene expression can be regulated by the process of methylation, which is an addition of a methyl group to a particular nucleotide within the DNA sequence that generally results in blocked or hindered gene expression. Basically, if a particular gene within the DNA gets methylated, there would be no RNA or proteins produced as a functional product. On an RNA level, the gene expression can be regulated by controlling how many RNA molecules are created or transcribed from one gene. Secondly, the RNA nucleotides can be edited, leading to a changed sequence and a different functional product. Some sections of the RNA molecule can also be removed or added. Lastly, to prevent the gene expression, the RNA can be degraded. On a protein level, the gene expression is regulated by controlling the amount of protein created from one RNA molecule through the process of translation, through the types of chemical modifications of the created protein which can change its activity. The gene expression would also be affected if the created protein doesn't reach its intended target organ. So the correct protein transportation is very important. And lastly, the protein can be degraded, which seizes the gene expression. Now, let's sum up the remaining molecules regulating the gene expression. The histone proteins that pack the DNA molecule into chromosomes in eukaryotes can undergo some chemical modifications that result in making the DNA more loose or more compact. This modulates the gene expression, more particularly the transcription of DNA into RNA. There are other proteins called transcription factors that directly bind to the DNA molecule, thus controlling the rate of gene transcription into RNA. Some enzymes can also regulate the gene expression through their involvement in the chemical modifications of the DNA, RNA, or the produced protein. MicroRNA is a short RNA molecule that can hinder the gene expression by specifically binding to the RNA transcript. To summarize, the presence of a gene does not conclusively determine whether or not it is actually active. The organisms tightly regulate the gene expression on every level, and if one of these pathways is obstructed, that would block the production of the functional RNA or protein. Thank you for watching. I hope this was as fun for you as it was for me, and that you learned something new today. You can like this video if you found it useful and interesting, and if you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll see you in the next one.